A prayer showdown in Carroll County. The battle over public prayer takes center stage in Carroll County.
Out of respect for my colleagues, I'm not sure how strongly they feel about it. I'm willing to go to jail over it. I believe this is a fundamental of America.
I pray, Lord, that you help each of us today to have wisdom and discernment and guide us as we make the decisions that are best for the citizens of this county. And thank you, Lord, for watching over us. I ask for a special blessing on each of the board members today. And I pray these things in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
I don't know who brought it up, but one of the guys said he thought we should open with prayer and the pledge to the flag. And I said I thought that was a great idea. And we talked about the fact that we would open the meeting, we would have a prayer, and we would take turns and just pray for each other as a board, and then have the pledge to the flag.
This began, I guess, initially when right when the Board of Commissioners first started, they implemented 10 governing principles, and one of them was to say a prayer at the beginning of every meeting.
If you go to the meeting, as I used to do, they would start the prayer, and of course, they expected people to stand during their prayer, so if you sat there, you really made an exclusion of yourself. But I reached a point, as others have, where you just get tired of going to the meetings and being an excluded class of individuals. I'm Neil Ridgely. I'm from Finksburg in Carroll County, and I'm here to talk to you today about the lawsuit that myself and two others have filed against the county regarding the secular prayer that the commissioners hold in their meetings.
In 2013, two Carroll County residents filed a federal lawsuit seeking the Board of Commissioners to stop saying prayers in the name of Jesus Christ.
I was offended when I was at a board meeting when they do that, because I think not only is it divisive and insulting to many of the people in the audience, but it's inherently coercive.
Well, we could pray, but we just can't use certain words like Jesus and Lord and Savior. And I think that that is an infringement on my First Amendment rights of free speech and free religion.
We do not believe that just saying the words Jesus Christ is in any way establishment of religion. The establishment clause is in the Constitution to protect the freedom of religion, and so that the government does not infringe upon the freedom of religion. We all agree that we didn't hang our rights on the doorpost when we came into the county office building, that we still have the rights of freedom of speech and of religion.
The founding fathers made it very clear that they wanted people to have freedom of religion. But they also made it very clear that they did not want to have a national religion or force people to believe in certain beliefs. There is no constitutional right to apply your religious beliefs on others. You can believe in Jesus, Muhammad, or if you want to pray to the moon, that's your right. But you really do not have a right to impose that belief on others.
Prayer is something that you actively engage in, and you may or may not. We don't ask people to stand or bow or join us in any way. We just pray for each other, and whoever wants to participate may.
It still puts people who are offended by that in a position where they have to make a snap judgment whether they want to humiliate themselves and get into trouble by walking out of the room, or whether they just have to stand and seem to go along with what is a violation of their constitutional rights.
The attorney for the county in this prayer case suggested that if you didn't want to participate in the prayer, that you could put your hands over your ears. Well, that's pretty preposterous. I'm particularly concerned, having been a former county employee, what would you do if you were county staff and they started to give the prayer and you stood there or sat there and covered your ears? Well, that's the end of your career, that's for sure.
And if we cease to believe that our rights come from God, we cease to be America.
It is alarming to me that the citizens in the United States would want to push God over to the side. If God goes away and we don't have inalienable rights from God, then we lose the battle on all of these fronts, because then man does become the one that decides what we do and what we don't do.
The last thing in the world I am is anti-religion. My feeling about this lawsuit, in which I'm really putting myself out quite a bit, is based on very sincere religious motivations. My mother was Presbyterian and my father is Roman Catholic, and I have followed the Catholic side of things and am a confirmed and very religious Catholic. I like to quote from the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 6, verses 5 through 7. And when you pray, do not imitate the hypocrites. They love to say their prayers standing up in the synagogues and at the street corners for people to see them. That's how we're supposed to pray. That's what it actually says in the Bible.
We're one nation under God, and we believe that that's where our inalienable rights come from, and they're delineated.
It's foundational, like I said, to our country, that we have a moral base, and the Judeo-Christian religion and the Bible is that base. That's where the truth comes from.
I believe in my own God. I have my own principles, which I can't say are unlike those of the Ten Commandments, but to ask others in a public meeting to participate and believe in them as well is just very wrong to me.
I think I'm the one whose rights to religious freedom under the First Amendment are being violated here, not the commissioners. Because when they speak in their official capacity, it's threatening and puts down people from other branches of Christianity or other religions at all.
They don't get it. That's my church. I pay for that church. That's my microphone. That's not theirs.
As far as praying publicly, the most inappropriate place to do it is in these government meetings.
We've been told to be careful, but we're going to be careful all the way to communism if we don't start standing up and saying no.
You know, I took an oath to uphold the Constitution, and when these things in the Constitution are challenged, it's our duty to stand up. Not speaking up when something is wrong is failure to lead.
The prayer has become a political tool for them. It's just something that they can put out there and say, see, we're good, strong Christians, and we want all you good, strong Christians to vote for us.
I think it's rank hypocritical political grandstanding. I don't believe any of their public statements about it. I think it's just a way to wrap themselves in the flag and the cross. There was one motions hearing in January.
There hasn't been a ruling on that, but that was to try to stop us from praying in the meanwhile until we go to court.
Recently, a federal judge, Quarles, issued a preliminary injunction that would stop the Board of Commissioners from offering sectarian prayers at the beginning of meetings. They would still be allowed to pray in God's name and a couple other terms, but they couldn't use Jesus Christ or Father or Savior, the terms that are specifically Christian.
The judge ruled decisively that what the commissioners are doing is government speech, that when they appear as elected officials in their, you know, in their official capacity at a public hearing, they're not there exercising their personal religious liberty rights, but they're there as public officials and they're speaking on behalf of the government.
Then we would have to make a decision of whether to take the next step, which is to continue to pray and see what happens, or to come up with an alternative to pray before the meeting, to pray on our own, whatever.
I just hope that there is respect paid. I hope that these commissioners will, understand that it's the law.
Commissioner Frazier.
Okay, before I pray today, I just want to say a couple things. Many may know that there was an injunction, if I'm saying the right word, that came down that said, oh, we could pray, but we just can't use certain words like Jesus and Lord and Savior. And I'm willing to go to jail over it. I believe this is a fundamental of America. In opening today, then, I'm going to read this prayer from George Washington.
Please do.
And it goes like this. O Lord our God, most mighty and merciful Father, I, thine unworthy creature and servant, do once more approach thy presence. Though not worthy to appear before thee because of my natural corruptions, and the many sins and transgressions which I have committed against thy divine majesty, yet I beseech thee, for the sake of him in whom thou art well pleased, the Lord Jesus Christ, to admit me to render...
The other group said, well, sometimes we say in Jesus' name or in his name, but we don't have to. So everyone, does it the way that they see fit. But they agreed with me that if that's the way I believe that our prayers would be answered, that that's how I should pray.
I saw the commissioner make it obvious that she wanted to make a political, if not religious, statement about the judge's decision, and then proceeded to use some text that is falsely accredited to George Washington as a prayer which twice mentions the name Jesus Christ. So it was as in your face a violation of the injunction as you can possibly get.
And I got a hold of a professor at Messiah University, and he said that it was, in fact, not a prayer from George Washington. It was a prayer that was believed to be in a book of prayers by George Washington, but it was later proved by the University of Virginia and the Smithsonian that they didn't actually, that wasn't George Washington's prayer. It was kind of a hoax.
It was decided to take the higher ground and a cooler route and send a warning letter. Actually, some of the other plaintiffs wanted immediate punishment for her as it is, but the cooler heads prevailed and the warning letter went out.
If I were Judge Quarles, I think I would want to have Commissioner Frazier appear in my courtroom and explain herself.
It's the commissioners as a group that are a party to this lawsuit. So what one individual does, unfortunately, reflects on all of them.
Guide us as we do the business of the citizens of this community. Help us to be faithful servants of your will. Bless all of our soldiers, both at home and abroad, and their families. Amen.
All right. First order of the agenda is public comment.
We have one card submitted thus far, Mr. Bruce Holstein.
My comments this morning were directed to Judge Quarles. I suspect he or his plaintiff's attorney is watching to make sure you don't say a prayer to Jesus Christ. Your Honor, when the political left got judges like you to overturn abortion laws, we Christians were deeply concerned about the mass murder that would be unleashed on this country. When the courts overturned marriage laws and allowed people of the same sex to get married, we Christians were told we must be tolerant of homosexuality. Now we have you, Judge Quarles, forbidding Christian conservative county commissioners from praying in the name of Jesus Christ. We are overruling Judge Quarles' objection by offering this prayer on your behalf. Heavenly Father, I stand here this morning and ask your blessing on our 5 county commissioners. This order discriminates against Christians and is a gross violation of our commissioners' First Amendment constitutional rights. Therefore, I ask you to bless their proceedings today and bless the case about Christian prayer before the Supreme Court. And I ask for these blessings in Jesus' name. Amen.
It was not a coincidence that he decided to do that. He's the campaign treasurer for Commissioner Rothschild and is a close associate of all the commissioners.
The attorneys for the plaintiff asked Judge Quarles for an immediate halt to all prayers in the county, and they also asked for $30,000 for the original situation involving involving the secretary in prayer at the commissioner's meeting, and then also asked for $10,000 every time somebody did it again.
Since it's been so blatant on their part, we thought that would be the only thing that would really stop them. It's unfortunate because any fines that it's applied against the commissioners could come out of the public treasury, so essentially the people of Carroll County. It did get their attention, I will say. And I think they finally started to listen to their lawyers.
The battle over public prayer takes center stage in Carroll County. A federal lawsuit is slamming the brakes on certain types of prayer at county commission meetings. WJZ is live in Westminster. Derek Valcourt explains why the commission's opening prayer is causing such a rift.
Commissioners could now be held in contempt for defying the judge's orders. That's why Tuesday, in a 3-2 vote,
all in favor,
aye.
The commission narrowly agreed to this resolution, saying for now their prayers will reference God, but not Jesus by name.
Essentially, they said that they were going to have either Commissioner Dave Roush or Haven Shoemaker give the prayer offerings before all the meetings by disallowing Commissioners Rothschild and Frazier to offer the prayers. It's not likely that they'll violate the court injunction again. So, we're still on a developmental stage, and I think we'll see how things play out.
It's still very early in the process. I mean, the case technically hasn't even started. This is as early on as you can get without really doing anything yet.
For the judiciary to step over and to tell elected officials what they can or cannot say is very troubling for all elected officials across our nation.
Like a blind man, I wonder, so lost and undone.
This is one nation under God. Our rights come from God. And the federal government can't take that away. Or the local government. Or a lawsuit.
And oh, what a difference since Jesus passed by.
I'm really quite tired of them using the office as a soapbox.
I think we're going to win. I think the commissioners are going to fight very hard. I think it's going to waste a lot of taxpayers' dollars.
We certainly, for the sake of America, want to see this to be in our favor. We believe that we've done nothing wrong except express our freedom of speech and freedom of religion.
It was a kind of Christian.
There will be an actual hearing at which time Mr. Hake and I and perhaps others and the commissioners will have an opportunity to testify before the judge.
My soul, and it's only made more certain as I look on his word. Since Jesus passed by, since Jesus passed by. Oh, what a difference since Jesus passed by. Well, I can't explain it, and I cannot tell you why. But oh, what a difference since Jesus passed by. All my yesterdays are buried in the deepest of the sea. That old load I used to carry.